Hello and welcome to the third annual installment of the top 14 CBS projections that they got wrong. This year, it's like taking candy from a baby. Last year, I was 29-11 on the rights and the wrongs, okay? Overs, unders. All the numbers you're going to see right here. If you're into fantasy baseball, you have to watch this video. And remember, these stats are from February 25th. So any projections that they have changed since February 25th, I'm sorry. Just go by the numbers that you see on the screen. Because they have been fluctuating a little bit from day to day. I've been checking it out here the last few weeks. But other than that, let's get going. Are you ready for some baseball? Say it's amazing what the designated hitter can do by resurrecting someone's career. If you look at it, there was a two-year period there where A-Rod could barely hit his way out of a wet paper bag. Suddenly last year, he resurrects himself by not having to play defense. 151 games he actually stayed on the field, hit 33 home runs in those games. Now, do you think he's going to play 151 games as he turns 41 on July 27th? No, I don't think so. And look at the second half swoon he had last year. Not to mention the whole Yankee lineup is another year older. What protection does he have there? No, I think it's a well below 30 home runs for A-Rod in 2016. Yes, we have our first retread from last year. Number 9. Last year was Josh Harrison. This year he's number 13. 2014 for Josh Harrison, career year. He hit 315, which well exceeds anything he's ever done any other year. And last year, I understand he had some injuries, and that's why he didn't have the enough at-bats and blah-blah-blah-blah-blah-blue. But that 315 batting average that he had in 2014, still, all those at-bats that he had, because he was only a part-time player in three of the other years he played, his career batting average is 284. Think about that. Career batting average of 284 with the 1 year at 315. So why do you think he's going to hit 289 this year? I have no idea. And 169 hits. I do see some projections that have him batting second, and maybe they'll let him do that. Maybe they'll start off the season with him batting second, but I don't think he's going to finish up there because guess what? He's just not that good. So under on both the batting average and the hits for Josh Harrison. Okay, I realize he's not as good as his fellow Cubans, you know, Cespedes and Abreu. I do understand that. But the CBS Sports line has 402 at-bats for him, and maybe that's all that he gets. You know, he's a poor fielder. I understand that. But even with 402 at-bats, you don't think he's going to hit 9 home runs and get 46 RBIs? I think Zach Greinke can hit 9 home runs. Well, maybe not. But still, in the desert, everybody hits, okay? Everybody hits down there. Tomas is good enough to get 9 and 46. So higher than 9, higher than 46. I'm still trying to wrap my head around this one. Okay, career whip of 113 for David Price. Now, you really think maybe it's because of his amazing big game pitching ability that he'll be able to handle the Fenway media and, you know, get comfortable there in his first year in a great pitcher's park in Fenway. Haha. Do you see the sarcasm there? No, I do not believe that he's going to have a 109 whip. That's crazy talk. I'm a little bit less confident about the 335 ERA. Maybe he could do better than that, but I don't think so. I think it's going to be higher than 335, higher than 109. David Price, not as good as those numbers. He'll still be solid. But come on. Fenway and the media, they're going to eat him up a little bit, don't you think? Thank you. sometimes I just don't know what CBS and Sportsline look at. Okay, 5 years ago, 2011, Tashira hits 35 and 95. That's the last time he put up those numbers. Okay, the projections right now, 35 and 92. How? Why? Okay, last year, you know, he was doing great. He was definitely on pace for these numbers. And, you know, he lost all the weight because he stopped drinking milk. But apparently he should have continued to drink milk because he fouled a ball off of his weak bones and broke his shin or whatever happened there. So, yeah, he's 36 in April. I'm not buying it. It's down for Tashira on both home runs and RBIs. We continue to drive down the what? Highway. Joey Bats. Okay, check this out. Three out of the last 4 years, he did not have 38-107. And now you've got all this, you know, crazy contract chalk going on. So he's got to put extra pressure on himself because I'm worth $30 million a year. No, you're not. You're old. Okay? You were worth $30 million a year. Now you might be worth $30 million this year, but you're not going to be after that. So now he's going to put all this pressure on him. And not to mention, Toronto's got a ton of pressure on him this year because of how great they were last year. No. 38-107. I think this could be considerably lower. Okay, not only do I think it will be lower, and it will be, home runs and RBIs, he's not hitting those numbers. I think it could be considerably lower, all right? 36, once again, I mean, you hit the 35 plateau and you start, yeah, no. This actually doesn't have anything to do with Matt Carpenter at all. In order to score 102 runs, you have to be surrounded by a fantastic lineup. I don't think the lineup is fantastic yet. Now, they're going in the right direction. I like Piscotty. I like Grychek. Holiday is good when he's on the field, but he's good for at least two or three DL trips a year. Molina is Molina at this point in his career. He's not what he used to be. The lineup is not strong enough to get you 102 runs, okay? I mean, like I said, Grychek and Piscotty, they're, you know, the not ready for prime time middle of the lineup order guys, okay? Just not yet. They're almost there, but not yet. Carpenter, 90 runs this year. Not 102. Marlon Byrd debuted in 2002. That is pre-Steve Bartman, okay? That's how long ago that was. And I think he's more of a fourth outfielder, believe it or not, with the Giants. They've got all kinds of outfielders going on there. So how is he getting 25 and 83? I'm not loving that at all. So, yeah. I don't even think he's going to get the at-bats to even come close to 25 and 83. So I'm way down. Marlon Byrd, way down in those categories. Oh my God, it would be so awesome to get 23 home runs out of a catcher. Considering this guy has a career high of 13. So why would we say he has 23? I don't know. That's a great question. I don't even think he's going to get to 20. Now I know, you know, you project the at-bats for Travis. He's actually going to get there if you give him a 550 at-bat season. But what freaking catcher gets 550 at-bats? Crazy talk. I don't even think he gets 20. Doesn't even get 20. Under 23, Travis Denard. It's amazing how everyone is such a what have you done for me lately. They completely forget about the amazing first half that Jock Peterson had, and they just remember the second half. Don't forget, dude's 23. Okay, he's only 23. Give him a chance. Now, I think this is one of the one single stat of all these that you can bank on. Jock Peterson is stealing more than four bases. His coach, his manager, is Dave Roberts. Do you think he might give a little bit more stolen base signs to his players than Don Mattingly? I'm pretty sure he will. Okay, so yes, Jock Peterson will 1,000%, yes, steal more than four bases this year. And 198? 198? Come on, 198. Guy has too good of an eye to hit 198. Yes, I know he hit 180 or whatever the second half of last year and everybody's freaking out about it. He's 23, okay? Give him a chance. This guy's a 30-30 talent. He's going to get there. Not this year. Not this year. He'll get there eventually. But he's going to hit higher than 198. He's going to steal more than four bases. Oh, my goodness. I know this is just an at-bat prediction, which is sort of weak, but you can kind of couple in any other stat that you see with Angel Pagan, knowing that he's not going to get 583 at-bats, so all of his counting categories are going to be a lot lower as well. 2 years out of the 10 years that the dude's played, he's had 500 at-bats. Why in the world now, at this stage of his career, is he going to get 583? What are they thinking? I mean, how? There's no way Angel Pagan gets 583 at-bats this year, so anything else that you see is going to be wrong too. But the actual prediction, 583 on the at-bats, way down. Way down. These keep getting better and better. Okay, last year, Chris Davis had 27 home runs in home run hitting friendly Miller Park. Now, he goes to the O.co, or whatever the freak it is, in Oakland, and he is going to hit 35? Why? Let's just put it in perspective. Josh Donaldson, in 2014, his last year in Oakland, had 29 home runs. Okay. So, you really think in a full year Chris Davis is going to hit 6 home runs more than Josh Donaldson in a full year? And these people get paid for this stuff. They get paid to say this stuff! Are you kidding me? Okay, and the other stuff. 122 hits? He had 122 hits in 2014 is what he had. They're projecting 138 hits for him. Why? 2014 was the career year for Chris Davis. He's not getting 138. 69 RBIs is what he had last year. So, let's put him at 91 this year. What do you say? 91 CBS and Sports Line. 91. No. All three of them way under. I don't know. Do not smoke the Chris Davis pipe. Let's put it that way. Don't do it. Okay, boys and girls, let's play a game. If you have a 1.35 whip, do you think you're going to have 40 saves in a season? No, of course not. You're not going to, because if you have that many people on base, you're going to blow at least, like, I don't know, 15 saves or something like that. So I would venture to say, if you have a 1.35 whip, and I'm in line to agree with such a stat, if you look at Trevor's last few seasons of control issues suddenly, that he might not even keep the job. I don't know if next in line is Seacrest or what. But that's neither here nor there. This guy is not saving 40 games next year. It's not happening. I'm not even sure if he keeps his job. So, I guess we're at number one. But you know what? There's so many of these that are wrong. I've got all kinds of honorable mentions. Let's keep going. Robbie Cano gets a bad rap. People think that he doesn't care, and that's why he didn't perform well in Seattle. However, if you look at the second half of the year, he did way better because he was healthy. It's an amazing thing what happens when your body doesn't reject you playing baseball every day. Oh my goodness. Anyway, look at the lineup that Seattle has. They now have Adam Lind, who's going to provide protection, and he mashes right-handed pitching. So Cano's going to see more pitches to hit. And you've got Aoki. And I know you're laughing right now because Aoki, ha 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 ha. Look at the lineups as Aoki is in them and after he leaves. They fall off the table because Aoki is a legit leadoff hitter. Leadoff hitters that are quality, very underrated. Cano, plus 80 in the RBI department. Just to show you I am not biased, I have a guy on my list that I had on for the opposite reasons last year. Mesoraco, 30 home runs and 85 RBIs, which was a ridiculous projection for last year. Catchers do not do this, but this year, 13 and 48. He's better than that. Now, I know that's based on 334 at-bats, but I think he's going to do better. I think he's going to get higher than 334. But the projections here are 13 and 48, higher than 13, higher than 48, Devin Mesoraco. Perhaps Will Myers is a guy that is just always going to be hurt. But I don't think so. I think he's finally at that stage where you gotta play to get paid. You know what I mean? And 240 and 385, he's better than if he can play the whole season. So higher than 240, higher than 385. The guy's got talents. He's a third-round pick. He's legit. He just has to stay on the field. I think he does, starting now. Adrian Beltre is 72 years old.
Actually, he's 36 years old. 36.
Okay, he's only 36. Even though it feels like he's been around since freaking 1985. But decline in health at 36 is definitely a possibility. I know he's had a history of being healthy, but to put up a 292-22-89 stat line, I'm not buying at this age. I don't think he's going to be on the field long enough to put up those numbers. So down for all three of those. As you can see, I am a Cubs fan. I would love Jake Arrieta to do that again. But as a fantasy baseball fan, I have to say, do it again. Do it again, man. Do it again. And you have all those postseason innings, and I know they're already backing him off a little bit because he hadn't had that kind of workload before. I don't see 18 wins, and I do not see a 106 whip. Those numbers are just crazy high. So I think he'll still be really good, obviously. I just not that great. Okay, I just think Gio was just the victim of a bad year last year. Okay, some bad luck, definitely some bad pitching. But going into last year, he averaged in a season 20 more innings than hits allowed. Okay, that says 1.33 whip is too high. I think he can beat that. He'll be better than 1.33. And a 3.81 ERA, there again, I think you can do better than that because he usually does do better than that. Just don't, like I said, just take last year as a flyer. Don't count last year. He's only 30 years old. It's not like he's lost all of his talent and he's forgotten how to pitch. He'll be good, so he's going to do better than the 381 and 133 that you see. Okay, sometimes I wonder when they do these projections if they actually look at the ballpark. Pittsburgh? Toronto? Tell me which one you'd want to pitch in, pitcher. It doesn't make any sense. And the only year that J.A. Happ had an ERA lower than 3.98 was last year. Okay, so why now that you've been traded to Toronto are you going to have an ERA that's better than 3.98? I don't know. And the wins, there again, since 2007, hasn't had more than 12 wins in a season. So what is happening here? I don't understand why he's going to have 13 now just because Toronto's going to score a bajillion runs. So I'm not buying either of those stats. And the whip in general doesn't make sense. So all three of them, down. You're pitching in Toronto, not Pittsburgh. Come on. Okay, this one's almost cheating because obviously he's been suspended for 30 games. So maybe, you know, that wasn't taken into account, you know, any kind of suspension for Chapman, even though it was given that he was going to get one. I personally thought he was going to get like 40 games, so the 30 games seems a little bit better for him. I can see him getting 30 saves, but I think 35 is out of reach, considering he also has to settle into pitching against American League batters in New York, and the same deal that, you know, Price has to deal with in Boston, Chapman's going to have to deal with in New York. So, here it is. The number one guy. He burned me last year. He better not burn me this one. David Ortiz is 84 years old.
Actually, he's 40 years old. Okay, just 40, Jason, all right?
I was all kinds of wrong with this guy last year, and maybe I'll be all kinds of wrong with this guy this year. I don't know because it just defies logic. I don't get it. If you're 40 years old, you shouldn't be hitting 34 and 99, and I'm maintaining that. It doesn't make sense. Throw him inner half fastballs and get it past him. Don't get it. The last 3 years, he's managed 500 at-bats. How? How? Look at the guy. How? How can you play a sport at an elite level when you're in that kind of shape and you're 40 years old? And you know what else? Here's something else that I think is going to be a drawback. He's having his Mariano Rivera-esque send-off. So every time, you know, he'll go to... Well, I was going to say Minnesota, but I guess that's not a good place. They probably don't want to give him a parting gift. That was like one of the worst trades they ever made. You know what I mean? He's going to go to Baltimore, and they're going to give him a stuffed home plate Oriole with popcorn that's gold plated or something. That doesn't make a lot of sense, but you know what I'm saying. His mind won't be on all baseball because he'll be so happy with all the gifts that he gets from opposing stadiums that, I don't know, there's a million things here. I'm maintaining that David Ortiz at 40 years old does not hit 34 home runs and does not hit 99 RBIs. That's what I'm going with. I hope you enjoyed this list. I really did enjoy it because it kind of makes me angry because I don't see a lot of these. I just don't see how all these educated people are saying these things and saying these numbers that people cannot hit. Or on the flip side, they're going to just far exceed. But anyway, I guess I need to cool down. The good news is that the season starts in a month. I'm ready. You should be ready. We all should be ready. Good luck, unless you're playing me. Thank you.